what made you initially interested in interior design?
I know when I went to college initially, I took an interior design class. So I probably was already interested in it, but that I became more interested once I took the class. And I just always remember when I was little, I loved to, I don't know if you ever did this too when you were little, I loved to do my room over.
Right.
Like we would rearrange everything, spend the whole day. And I just remember that, and I couldn't wait to go to bed at night, look at my new space. But probably, you know, I probably always had an interest, but definitely that class that I took in college.
Cool. So, based off of your college class, did what you majored in college coincide with what you do now?
No, I wound up majoring in, because there wasn't anything for interior design, only like fashion design. So I wound up majoring in psychology. But I do think there's such a psychological background, or like with any kind of type of design,
mm-hmm.
you know what I mean? Just like working with clients and figuring out what they like, there is a little bit of that in there, but not really.
It's like seems to be a major, really, like I know Grace majored in psych too.
Yeah.
So that's
I know, because it's so like vast, I think.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and I'm interested in that. I don't know if that wound up happening, but so what kind of experience do you have in interior design?
Well, I became a stager. I was a certified stager, where I staged homes before they, like with the realtor, before
mm-hmm.
they would sell it. And then also, I worked with a friend of mine. Well, I became friends with her through organizing. So when I was a professional organizer, we eventually became more interested in the design aspect. So that's why we became certified in stagers. And then what we did, instead of just staging homes when they're about to sell, we started working with people to stage to live. We called it stage to live. So it's like going to someone's house and even work with what they had and kind of like move it into different rooms and kind of stage for them or find out like, oh, you need a rug here, you need a lamp. So we wound up doing that.
Yeah, that's super interesting. I didn't know that. So what is your first priority when like restarting a room or renovation, like when you did your staging, like where'd you start?
With the organizing,
mm-hmm.
you know, we started there working through trying to get rid of things really that serve no purpose or that kind of keep being moved from room to room or just stuff where you didn't have a place to put. So we definitely worked with weeding out and organizing. And then we would work with what people have instead of right away being like, oh, we need a new couch, we need this. It was like, what do they have? Like even looking around the house to see what other items we could use in that space.
So like repurposing things.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah,
yeah,
what you want to do.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
Do you have like a signature style of how you like to decorate a room?
I love like farmhouse style,
mm-hmm.
or like that rustic style.
Yeah.
Like fixer upper.
Mm-hmm.
You know, like I absolutely love that, and a lot of whites, which I probably don't always do in my own home, but I would love to do that for other people.
Yeah.
Because white just sometimes scares you. You know, you're like.
Yeah.
You have everything white when, you know, when the kids were little. It's like,
What advice would you give to someone renovating a room for the first time, in particular an office space?
The best advice I would give is you want to create a space that makes you happy.
Mm-hmm.
So it really is about what works for you, not like, oh, offices are supposed to look like this or I need to have this. Really just starting with what makes you happy, and also the color too should be like that color that a brighter color that really wants to inspire you more than you know, like a
yeah.
dull or dark color. It could be fun color, but when you're in the space for a long time you want something that inspires you.
Yeah. What colors do you like using in rooms? Like
I love, and I know you're going to use, right, like a light
yeah.
blue or whatever.
Yeah.
Absolutely love that color.
Mm-hmm.
Like my dining room's that color, my bedroom. Definitely blues and grays.
Yeah.
You know, lighter colors, lighter blues and grays I love.
Have you found, my research has, like, shown that, like, gray is, like, a neutral color and sometimes even, like, dulls you, but have you found that to be any, have a dulling impact on you or no?
No, like the darker ones probably.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
But the brighter ones, no. But definitely, I think so. With the darker ones, I had
really?
One in our back room, and for not even a year, and I think we changed the color. And really? I loved it in a friend's house when I went after, yeah. But it was just like, yeah, it just there's something about it that brought me down. So we changed the color. Yep.
So yeah, it's super interesting. That's exactly why I didn't want to make my room gray, because I was like, the whole point of it was really, like, promote productivity in the room. So I was like, but I do like Kaylee's room is super cool. It's gray, right? Like a lighter kind of.
Yeah.
Yeah, so
you know,
I,
but
I like
it's
that
a
lot.
Yeah. That's like a different. Like, there's so many,
grays,
especially grays, right?
So, tell me about your interior design project that you've done in your own home, and which are you most proud of?
Well, it's so funny when I think, because when I was looking at the questions, I have done probably every room, but I usually like if I worked with a client, it's so different when you're working with someone else. Telling them what to do, they want to like finish a room, and you know, you tell them what to do, they get everything done, and you follow through, and it's complete. In my own home, I'm always like, I'll start a project, and like, it's almost done, and I'm not really sure, you know, what curtains to do, so let me move on. You know, so I feel like I do have rooms that aren't finished, but probably my favorite is my kitchen. And I remember wanting to go with white cabinets, and people would be like, white cabinets, or you know, you listen to what people say, or you think you're like, oh, you start to question yourself, and you're, and I absolutely love it. Like, it just makes me happy every time I'm in there.
Do you have a favorite space or kind of room that you like designing the most? Would be a kitchen? Or?
No, actually, probably living rooms or like family rooms.
Really? Yeah.
Yeah, just because, like, sometimes, like, when we would go into people's homes, they might not have even used the space because it was just like, the way they had it set up or had too much stuff in it or it wasn't cozy. So once we worked with them and, you know, sometimes it was only adding a cover for a couch or a rug and switching the couches around in a different position, we always created a space that then people loved and they totally hung out in. So I love that.
Where do you go shopping when decorating your home?
I love Marshalls, Home Goods, those are my favorite.
Mm-hmm.
Even IKEA could
really?
Be, like, it's awesome now, and it's so much fun to get ideas. And I do love, like, random, like, markets. Like, there's a Clover Market is a market out by, like, Villanova, but it has all, like, repurposed furniture and all that stuff. So I love finding, like, places like that, too. Mm-hmm. And then you'll find a friend of mine. And we'll both go and come home with a piece. Like, she found a desk for her daughter that she still has. I have a table in the back room. Yeah, it's just funny. We're, like, shoving it in the car, you know.
So do you ever, like, paint those on your own, or do you just buy them?
I do, but, again, just like I said, sometimes I don't finish a room. I'll be honest. I paint it, and I'm all into the project.
You don't take it, Rudy.
And then I move on. You know what I mean? So I don't know if I have anything here that, you know, most of it, I love painted furniture, but it's always, like, all buy it or have someone paint it.
Do you find those, like, places where you shop, like Home Goods and stuff, is also, like, affordable, so it's not, when you do projects, not too expensive?
Yeah, that's, yeah, absolutely. Mm-hmm. That's one reason, because it's affordable. And then they just have so many, like, there's just so many ideas and so many different things, and it always changes.
Mm-hmm.
Like, you'll go there 1 week and look, and maybe you don't find anything, and 2 weeks later you find stuff. But absolutely for price, too, because I love that when people are, like, shocked at what you could do
how
much money. Because if people don't have any kind of sense of decorating or they don't normally do that, they have no idea. They just see things like, oh, my God, that's such a beautiful room, and that catches them, you know, $3,000, and they think there's no alternative. So I love that to share, you know, share that with people that, oh, my gosh, you could do so much for a little bit of money.
Do you ever use websites like Pinterest or anything?
Yeah.
You do?
I do. I love Pinterest. And I know a lot of people are doing that now, like finding a room on there.
Yeah.
And just really decorating from that,
like
which
that.
Is so cool to see. I know a few friends who did that, like showed me the picture, and it's like they found, you know, like the same things here and there and did their research, and the room looks very close to it.
Yeah, I found the color for my room.
On Pinterest?
No, and on Instagram, they had apparently, like, there, the paint brand was making a, like, having a contest to construct little homes.
Okay.
And
oh, cool.
they had like a whole chart of like colors that work best for like small houses or small rooms.
Spaces. Okay.
So I'm like, oh, this color's that.
Perfect.
And I like the there's like a cobalt or like navy blue, and I love that. But my bedroom's navy blue, so
okay.
And my brother's room is also blue, so I'm like, I can't have three like darker blue rooms.
Yeah, right.
So
it would be nice to have something different.
Yeah, I chose the lighter blue. So what is the best or worst piece of advice or criticism that you've received when designing a room?
I'll go with the best because that's what I could, think of. This one, I guess their best like compliment or whatever, or, she just did everything that we asked her to do, like every suggestion we gave her,
mm-hmm.
She was very diligent and did it, and it was unbelievable to see the transformation and to see how, like, she was like, oh my gosh, I'm so happy because now she used her kitchen, she used to not really use it,
mm-hmm.
And then her same thing I was saying before, like her living room, she never used the space, and her family now like use the space to hang out and, you know, to watch TV or read,
mm-hmm.
And, you know, for different purposes. So that was probably like the best that she just always, that she said she did everything, and then she would always send us like little notes about how happy,
cute.
You know, like today I had people over for tea and I could have them in my kitchen because we put like a little island in there or whatever.
That's nice. And before, you mentioned how people said like don't do a white kitchen, the cabinets, and then you're like, you don't regret not listening to them.
It's like you gotta go with your gut,
mm-hmm.
You know, which is hard to do, I think,
yeah.
When you're decorating, because you could,
mm-hmm.
listen to a lot of people and see so many different things, and you know, it's hard.
So finally, are there any last pieces of advice you'd like to give me to help me in my process of redoing my room?
The one thing I can say, and I probably said it before too, but it is like, go with your gut and do what makes you happy, because there really is no, there's no rules.
Mm-hmm.
And I think some people think there are. Like, you know, just like you're not supposed to wear white until after Memorial Day, whatever that silly thing is. Like, there are no rules, even, you know, when it comes to decorating too. It doesn't, you know, you should totally let that go and just
mm-hmm.
do what you think. Like, it'd be so cool to do, you know, this in the corner, do it, you know, because it's your space and you're the one that's going to live in it.
Mm-hmm.
So do what makes you happy and brings you joy.
Yeah, I just thought of another question. Do you like using picture frames and like little, I see, you know, like even I have in my house, the little like saying signs. Do you use those in like all of your rooms?
I do like them. Yeah. Oh my gosh. You got to see Anna Lean's house.
Really? Yeah, I saw.
Oh my gosh, yeah, maybe we should be interviewing her. But she has, like, you know, because she just moved in. It's
mm-hmm.
funny, too, which is nice. So she starts with a clean slate.
Yeah.
It's hard when you're in a house for so long to do that. But she has a lot of those in her decorating, and I love that.
Yeah, I want to add some to my room.
And again, because, yeah, it's another thing. Like, I have something by the door when you go out. It says, today I choose joy.
Mm-hmm.
And I love that. And I will catch it sometimes when you're, like, think you're not in the best mood.
Yeah.
And I'm like, yeah, I am choosing that today, you know, so it's neat.
Thank you.
Yeah. Thank you. All
right.